for so long, my brothers and sisters. We're meant to believe that we're put here to destroy and the change that we had to do. We were made to create. We were made to find balance with this world and as we reach out beyond. And we can still have that come to us. Even by the time this star has run out of the energy to surpass even Mercury as a sustainable life force. We can use our adaptability and intelligence. Perhaps there's species out there now watching us, trying to understand where they were at one time, how they became what they are. I only hope and pray that they have the love, they understand that we're correct, that I'm correct, that every ounce of my being of what God perceives and is to me, to become more. If we're going to become more, we have to put away hatred. We have to put away corruption. We have to look at one another as brothers and sisters, as family. When I see another person's child, I would think of that child as my own. I would give it the respect and love and the patience necessary. There are statements that it takes a whole village to bring up a child, and it is so much truth to that. When I was in Newfoundland, and I know that the knowledge and understanding I have now, I would not use to the degree. We spanked our children back then. It was an understanding. Our Bible taught us that. And perhaps you still do that to a small degree. But as we grow, as we become more, we start to understand that it doesn't always have to be that way. We do it sometimes because these children's minds and bodies have been poisoned so badly and wrecked and destroyed before they even get to grow up. And we're so angered because they're out of control, but they're out of control because of the lack of vitamins and the minerals and the food and the diets. The poisons we put into our own temples is what creates the cloudiness. And then you've got an unruly child who's angry with themselves and they don't know how to control or even reach out. They don't know what's going on within themselves. Their minds are developing. Their emotions are out of control. And there is an answer. The tree of life will change all of that. And I have no way to explain that to anybody. Nobody believes. Very few. A handful of this whole world. 0.001% of this world knows without a doubt what the tree of life is. That this tree can heal the nation. Can heal our minds. Can heal our hearts. Can heal our souls from the poisons of the tyrannic... Forgive me, this isn't my own will. I get so emotional, I have trouble holding it. Oh, brothers and sisters, this tree of life is so true. It's so true. I've seen it. It healed me so much. My body. Perhaps I don't believe I'm supposed to keep this knowledge to myself. I will keep screaming it out until I die. I'll tell strangers on buses. I'll tell people of all walks of life, of all ages of life, if they're interested. There is a time right now, in the last 2 years, I am getting tired because, to be honest, I don't know if it reaches anybody. I don't know if anybody even hears me. But I need the evidence. I need the proof that people need. And this sad, forsaken, sorry life created by the corruption and evil. There is not enough faith, not even for myself, that I have enough faith that God almost had to poke me with a stick several times to get my button gear in the directions necessary. Boom! Here's a sign before you. I guess what it comes down to, my friends, my brothers, my sisters, it comes down to your will, your choice. Do you sit on the couch and you continue watching the box and you have them tell you what to believe? And you follow the things of culture. And you make sure you're dressed the right way. And you make sure you have the right furniture. And you make sure you have the right looks. The right attitudes. Everything that the world needs to perceive. All the while you look away from the hurt and the suffering and the pain. These people we call propagandas. It's not all propaganda. It's not all fake belief. It's not all made belief. It's not even made up. It frustrates me to such a high level of degree. I'll tell you, without this change that's coming, we won't get off our butts. We won't get up and do the things that are necessary. We're so cowed like now, I don't even know how to begin to even reach out to get this. But when this change comes, I sure hope, I sure pray. I hope and pray that I'm ready for it. I know so many truths now, my brothers and sisters. I was going to share you another secret and I completely forgot about it. I got off track and to be honest, I can't recall what it is. There's been a few of them. Understandings, aspects of what, perhaps. When this change comes, I hope we get to learn to break down those barriers. Because we won't be able to run to our TV screens, they won't be able to hold us and control us for a period of time. When this change comes. And when that change comes, they're going to be in a position where, well, they're prepared for it actually, we're all not. They're going to come out in full force and try to put their power over us when that time comes. And try to enforce even more so on us. But it's going to be a great deal of difficulty because their communications aspects will be very, very limited to what it would have been. And it'll take them a year or two to get back to where they were. And in that period of time, people are going to start to change. Because they'll have no government to help, there's going to be a tremendous horror right away. The lack of food and everything. There will be no superstars that can help us. So people are going to be struggling on a mass level of scale. Do we turn on against one another? They're going to pull governments out. They're going to pull army people out with guns to walk the streets where we used to be free and safe. There'll be no electricity for a period. Some people will have it. They'll use gas and whatnot, get the generations and generators going of what's left. I wonder what transformers, power, grids, satellites. I always wondered if that was the thing I seen the angel showed me falling from the sky. Because I wasn't afraid of what was falling from the sky. I always wondered that it was because it was not the end of the world. It had more to do with the change that was coming. Is this change caused by us? I don't know. Perhaps this change is normal and expected, but with our own foolishness, we started to play with advancements of what we're capable of and created more difficulties than what necessarily would have been, so that it'll extend further and leave them a little off base. But in a year's time, people will have become self-sustained again. Everybody will be growing their own vegetables and food right from their own yards. There's no superstore. People are starving to death. You're holding on to what little things you have. You're bartering everything you have. There's no work. Very little. We're trying hard to get it back. I mean, there is work, but it's nothing compared to what it was. Not like it is. The government's taking care of what's left. They're using walkie-talkies now. I don't know why I keep seeing all these. Maybe it's coming, I don't know. But these are all these things I keep seeing coming. Anyway, my brother and sister, this change is going to bring, it's going to bring forward and show the true corruption of these people. Of how they can maintain us. When things start to come, and they're afraid that they might lose their control. They will put police upon the streets in abundance, and the army will walk the streets in abundance to make sure for our own safety, they will say. They've taken anything we can to protect ourselves, so these people now, some of them will be able to walk right into your homes late at night and justify it. Horrible atrocities will take place because of it on people's rights and lives. And when it all ends, and the tip and the table balances again and the connections are reestablished and the internet, they'll hold the internet down. They'll put switches on everything. They're already prepared and ready for this time that's coming. They know of it. Perhaps they did what they did on purpose. They want to make this much more damaging than anybody could ever expect or even see or even believe while they hide themselves under the Earth's protection. They get ready to take care of part of their world. Not everybody, but just the ones that are important to them. It's going to be an atrocities, brothers and sisters. And that's when the Tree of Life will come forward. And that's when they won't even see it coming out before, beyond, when it's too late on them. People are going to try to survive in any means, aspect, any way and form. And when they understand there are places upon this earth that the word gruel once met, that people could sustain whole civilizations, societies, lived off of it. We know the word is gruel, but it had many words and names over the years. Not a yummy tasting thing, trust me. You would rather be chewing on cardboard boxes, but my friends, you do. Like, wonderful thing God made us is an adaptability, where you actually can get used to things, so that you will even miss it at time later. You'll miss the taste, and because of that, it's going to start healing our people, healing our bodies, healing our minds. Every aspect of the Tree of Life. It will heal you, brothers and sisters. This Tree of Life that's coming. It will heal the nation. And people will start to find their voices again. As these changes come and they start to realize that this tree will save them from the starvation that would have existed. For its growth is unsurpassed by any other. And its food is in abundance. As you take from it and reap whole huge fields and acreages of it. Because nothing else can grow as quickly. Everywhere in abundance. And as it does, it will heal the minds of people. And they will find the love again. It is only because they are clouded and damaged by the minds and the corruptions of those above. They know how to hurt your temple, brothers and sisters. They know how to cloud your mind, how to make you not even know what the truth is. So, to each and every one, thank you for dropping by to the Prophecy 222 channel. I've shared my messages that were given by God. That I believe. It could be no more than the delusional people aspects out there. But for what's been given and shown to me, it would be wrong of me not to try to share with others. And I'm not ready to give this whole knowledge of understanding of what maybe some of you have already glimpsed it, perceived it, and figured it out for yourselves. But I know if I leave it a mystery, an error of mystery, perhaps you'll hang on a little longer, because the world, when you do find out, you'll do as everybody does, I promise you. You will turn away in disgust and dismay. You won't even take one step forward to even challenge this belief. You'll come up with a conclusion, and it'll be me who's disillusioned from your perspective. Which is so wrong from my perspective, because I have solid proof in my eyes. I've seen, and I can't get anybody else to do. You have to do for yourself, brothers and sisters. Bless you all. Thank you for coming here. Thank you for dropping by. And you have yourselves a wonderful day, a blessing day. And know how much a blessing life is. Be thankful every day when you look outward. When it's raining, when it's sunny, when it's any day that you have breath, air to fill your lungs. Be thankful. And blessings to all of you. I hope suffering and pain doesn't have to be with you. Being a necessity sometimes of growth. Thank you, and amen.